But speaking of death, though, you know who is going to die? Me, because I don't like this fucking trailer. Black Panther, it's out.
What?
Oh, That's a shock. It's never happened.
don't kill him yet.
Because here's the thing, man. I don't know what you guys think about this shit, but I mean, like, this trailer is cool. It does everything that, you know, you want from Captain America, Civil War, etc. You know, Black Panther's cool. But I can just tell this could be the exact same thing that Wonder Woman was, where they go into some kind of thing. Like, I love where Black Panther's from. What's it called?
Wakanda.
Yeah, it looks cool. It's futuristic. It's badass. Like, I like it. I can tell that's going to be 5 minutes of the fucking movie. And then everything else is going to be typical chasing after cars, slow motion, fucking silly shit. You know what I mean?
I don't know. I don't get that vibe watching this. But, you know, again, this is only a teaser, so who knows?
True.
Yeah, when they release the next 300 or 400 to 500 trailers, we'll see, you know, the rest of it.
Exactly.
Yeah, like, I'm looking over here, too, and, I mean, like, this is cool, too, these little sword fights or whatever. I can tell it's not going to last long. But then it's, like, weird to have, like, the street. I mean, I know they're trying to show you the entire movie or showing the best parts, but it's, like, you literally have a moment where he's, like, hiding, like, you know, Solid Snake in the fucking woods, and he's, like, a serial killer almost. And then, what the
fuck? That was awesome.
Wait,
dude, that would be awesome if you did that Metal Gear, like, you know, when they start.
Yeah. Well, it's
something that, like, yeah, he brings a point, like, it could be that, but we won't know until we see more and more trailers. But something that I didn't like as I was watching it is, like, you and Gunter probably bring this up as well, you didn't really see much of the character, but right at the end shot, like, there was a cool shot, you know, when he's doing the whole flipping over there. But this particular frame here, I don't think the background meshes well or is in the same layer as the foreground. So it just looks weird. Like, the movie just became ultraviolet for no reason. Like, the movie ultraviolet. So it just feels like
Ghost in the Shell.
Yeah. Like, it just became a different movie. So that could still be in Wakanda, but that might be in New York. Like, this movie might end in New York at some point.
Yeah, and I think it's almost obvious. Like, I think he's definitely going to leave Wakanda and start doing shit. I said that wrong. I know.
No, it's Wakanda.
I'm going to name my baby Wakanda.
Nick Diaz.
Oh, my little Wakanda. No, but, like, the thing is, like, you can tell, man, this is definitely not, like, in that African type of place. This is a totally American fucking New York or Chicago or something.
Maybe.
And the thing is, I would hate if it's both of those things put together again, because it doesn't blend well. Like, you had this whole, like, you know, I don't know if you can call it tribe or army or whatever the case may be, but, like, the other characters, his family, his people, they look different. They seem different. I want to know what makes them tick. Do they have, like, rivalries within each other? Do they have a lot of other shit going on? And, I mean, I'll know this once we see the movie or see other trailers. But they showed a lot of shit in this teaser, and I feel like, you know, all the different locations that they've showed in the trailer, I feel like I already seen a fucking movie. Unless it's like 2.5 hours long, I just saw everything.
It's strange because I don't know what expectations anyone else had, because walking in, I was like, oh, it's a teaser. It's going to be, you know, 30 seconds of nothing, and then Black Panther shows up. So the fact that this is, to me, like, almost like a regular trailer, so I was kind of more surprised at that. But what I like is it's a bunch of images. I don't actually know what the movie's going to be about. I'm worried it's going to be just kind of plain, but it does look like it could be something interesting. I like seeing futuristic Africa. Right. Like, that to me is, I think, hopefully they stay there. Hopefully they don't do a situation where they leave, like, in Thor or something.
Yeah.
I want a situation where it's like, I don't mind if the movie goes back to America, because you got to connect them to the MCU. But having most of the movie, or even the first, like, 2/3 being in Wakanda would be cool, because no, like, they can do whatever they want with that. Futuristic Africa in a place nobody knows exists, like, they could do a lot with that.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. And jumping off of the hype of Wonder Woman, because I know Ellie's seen this, what, 3 times now, girl?
Yep.
Wow.
God damn it. No, but, I mean, like, what did you feel watching this trailer? Because you messaged us in the chat, like, this is fucking lit! Like, you know, you're...
Yeah!
I mean, this is lit!
I'm excited! I see, like, all of your guys' concerns are, and I totally get it, and I'm concerned as well. But it's just really cool because it's something I feel like we've not really seen in comic books before. And just like in film before. Something of this caliber where it has like all of these actors that, you know, who are black doing these really powerful roles and not being like a stereotype, you know? Like, and it shows Africa in a good light, even though Wakanda is a fictional country. But still, I bet there's a lot of people. There are a lot of people in the world who thinks that all of Africa is a third world continent. There's like no such thing as internet or like running cars, and it's just not the case. And hopefully, this movie kind of helps in that regard. to kind of show people, like, hey, we can be all modern too. Like, we have a lot of places in Africa that's just as advanced as anywhere else in the world.
Yeah, so... check out our hover cars.
Hey, you know what? I'd rather than think that Africa has hover cars than, like, all these diseases and children dying and starving everywhere, you know? Like,
yeah. But the whole thing, though, that I want to bring up before I get to Adrian is the fact that, like, I'm afraid that this is becoming too prioritized of, in the sense, like Wonder Woman, like, oh, God, I'm going to make some enemies, holy shit. But, like, with Wonder Woman, it was like, no, it's a girls movie, feminism, yay! And the whole fucking thing. And I feel like Black Panther is going to try to do a thing where it's like, it's black. No, but we got a black superhero. No, black. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. I'm happy that y'all doing that. But, I mean, is it good, though? Like, because Moonlight was not good. I'm sorry to say, Ruth, there's no reason to chat, but that fucking movie sucks. Like, it's the same fucking thing.
Nick, wow. You disappoint me.
Nick, I'm disappointed. Just, that was my favorite movie.
I don't know. I kind of
think
on the Moonlight. Yeah.
No, I agree. That was the only time me and Nick agreed on, like, artsy movie. Like, I really just like Moonlight.
And like, here's the thing. It's not for me, but the thing is like, I had never heard anybody talk about the movie without mentioning the blackness of it. They didn't mention how good the story was or how emotional it was. It's like, no, it's a good movie. It's black.
But like, that's, the whole thing is that it's about black cultural identity. I mean, that it's not to say it's a black movie, like, you know, oh, this is only made for black people. But the topic is black cultural identity in terms of, you know, how you relate to people with violence, how do you relate with, like, your sexual identity kind of thing. That is the core of that movie.
There's so little dialogue in the movie. Yeah. Most of that is just inferred. But that's where we're straying from the point of...
Yeah, let's go back to the main point.
Yeah, Adrian. Of course, yeah. But, like, the main thing is, like, and I like how Tango's Nick going to die.
That's why I brought protection!
No, because that's the thing, too. You know, I just feel that way with Black Panther, because this just looks like, you know, the first Captain America to me, just with the black guy. And I hate the first Captain America. That's the dumbest John Cena fucking movie. Like, it's basically wrestling in a movie. It's fucking silly.
And, what?
What?
I hate wrestling.
Nick, just stop.
Yeah, come on.
I'm sorry, but that guy's John Cena or Hulk Hogan or The Rock. Like, he's that guy.
No,
like,
I'm not disparaging your opinion, but I want to know how you got to there.
He's so perfect. The fact that what's his Chris Evans or whatever, like, he is like, literally they dumped the man in some super juice and the motherfucker comes out and he's amazing. He's the perfect man. And no way in a movie I'm like, maybe he's not gonna win. Maybe there's gonna be a bad guy that's gonna take over. It's like the whole movie I'm just watching a dude who's fucking incredible. And it's not interesting to me.
But you're okay watching scripted wrestling then, right?
Because it's not done that way. Like, I mean, there's times where it is done that way, and I don't like that shit. But, like, I like those characters. I don't like John Cena. You see what I'm saying? Like, wrestling gives you many different things. And you don't watch it, so I don't know how you're even going to try to, you know, whatever. But it's just one of those things where, you know, and I can admit that wrestling's stupid sometimes, just like in the sense of Captain America. I like some comic book movies, but Captain America is definitely not one. Winter Soldier was different because you felt like, oh, shit, Chris Evans has a lot of shit he has to deal with.
Okay, I'll let you have that one. All
yeah,
right.
That's fair, because, you know, because that's the thing. The first one is, like, he's supposed to be naive but still capable. Like, he's not a bumbling idiot, but in the second one, he grows into being, like, completely unsure of, like, if he's doing the right thing almost the entire movie.
Exactly, and then even in Avengers, you know, like, the enemies seem like, oh, shit. Like, it was like, oh, my God. And even Captain America Civil War, you know, like, everyone looks badass. Black Panther looks badass. Everyone looks cool. So it's kind of like, you know, it's not all the Captain America show. You know, I got to see everybody else do a good job.
Thanks. But no, in all seriousness, I mean, look, every Marvel movie, they have a pattern. They have a formula they've established because that's how movies work. They always have the same structure of superhero types kind of thing. So I just say I judge them on a film-by-film basis. It doesn't matter if it's stuff I've seen before. It's just if it's executed well, if I care, if I like the characters, if it's made well. And I mean, this looks like it's got high production value. You know, it's shot well. It's got good, you know, art set design. It's most of the same team Coogler's ever worked with, you know, all the cinematographers and editors and that stuff. There were three things that really stood out to me. One is I like the way they re-envisioned Manape as just some dude with a huge, crazy monkey mask. because that thing is freaky looking when you see him put it on. Yeah, that's some intense stuff there. Two, also, it's nice to see that Bilbo and Gollum are going to have another scene together.
I saw that. My first thought was, oh, they somehow managed to get Andy Serkis back to this. I guess Ultron didn't kill anybody.
No, he just cut off his arm and now he's the Claw. So, but then the thing I liked the most is when I saw Michael B. Jordan show up, I'm just like, oh my gosh, they cast him as the Weeknd in this movie. Because that hair.
No, it's the Joker. I have the proof.
I still don't see that, man. I saw that picture. But, you know, and all joking aside, I mean, it's going to be interesting to see Michael B. Jordan play a villain, because he's only really played protagonists and, you know, kind of charming characters. So here he's playing the lead bad guy, with a bad guy name for you, Erik Killmonger. So...
Okay, like, how does that not seem silly?
And that's what I'm saying. Like, it's a certain style. Like, I'm okay with things being hyperbolic or goofy if it fits the tone of that movie. Because, I mean, you know, again, like, we got Guardians of the Galaxy where that stuff's just super goofy, you know, and people still love that kind of stuff. You know, and I don't, or even, what is it? The bad guy in Iron Man 1 was the Ironmonger or something like that. You know, it's like, if you can still buy it, even with its goofiness, I don't mind. So... And again, this teaser is too little. There's not enough in here to really make a firm assessment of the movie. It's just a little like, here's what we've got coming, and then we'll see where it turns out the next trailer.
Exactly. Yeah.
Before I get to my positives, I will say one negative. It's really going to be hard for me to see Michael B. Jordan as a villain, because seeing him back in stuff like Chronicle and especially The Wire, it's going to be interesting how they make him to an actual believable villain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's my one little interesting nitpick, but really it's nice to see a movie with this much production value and see us as a culture move beyond movies like, you know, Blank Man and Steel and Meteor Man and see like an actual movie of this type with some high production value. So I'm really excited for this in February.
I like the music too. Like, here's another thing. I really liked how they made a modern soundtrack to the trailer where it gets you hyped. I hate that big like orchestra, like, oh, and yet there's a man with a cape on. I'm like, this is not fucking epic. This is silly.
But that's the thing that I'm the complete opposite of you. I like that because it's like, it's trying to send some sort of awe and that this person's not above mortals. Every time I hear this, I keep thinking this is just Marvel hip hop track number 72. Every fucking thing from the TV shows to every movie to fucking Guardians. Like, Guardians sticks with the 80s stuff. Same thing with Thor. Then you have the TV shows that go with the hip hop. The only time this ever done well was Luke Cage. And I thought that was unique for the thing there. Then they did the exact same thing in Iron Fist. And now with Black Panther?
Rashad, how about you, man? Like, I mean, what do you feel about, for one, what do you feel about my bullshit and me talking and everything?
I'm not sure how you got to the John Cena, but I'm just going to leave that to the side. But, like even, like, just looking at this, God bless Marvel for giving all these human torches that Fox has ruined a second time. Fox has ruined two human torches, and they, like, Mark said, like, you know what, we're just going to give both of y'all jobs. Y'all deserve better than this. And we're just going to make you Captain America. We're going to make you a villain.
Like, hey, apparently that's a great way to get a career. Do the Fantastic Four reboot when it fails.
And meanwhile, Miles Teller's just like, I'll do something. Anyone else wants to?
I'll do something.
I'll be back on character number 5, I promise.
But, like, especially, like, I do get the feeling that, like, okay, like, a lot of Marvel movies follow a certain pattern, a certain set. Like, it kind of, like with Spider-Man, I feel like that there's a big formula. Like, I'm looking forward to it. But I feel that big formula just there. But with this and Thor Ragnarok, I don't feel that formula at all. They feel like the most freshest of the movies that are getting ready to come out to me. Like, of the Marvel Universe, I mean.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No, I completely understand, too. Like, I mean, especially with Ragnarok's going to be so fucking stupid, dude. I swear to God.
I am so afraid of that, though.
I hope that fucking movie just gets canceled somehow. Like,
Ragnarok
is going to be epic.
Now, everybody out at the same time. Go. The reason I got the bat is not for European, Nick. People probably already assumed that in the beginning. No, it's not. This is for my self-defense. I thought this was the most mediocre trailer I've seen in a while, man.
Yes.
Dude. All right, where do I start? The CGI at the end was very choppy. No, it's not even that bad, Nick. It's just I hate when movies have the CGI effect. They do it so sloppy and they throw in the trailer. Because they want you to see how awesome their effects is, but they don't give it another rendering process. So it looks like real, it looks like a video game, and then real person on top of the car. Like, you can see the cut. Second of all, the dialogue in this, which is very, very little, is very, like, okay, it's just another superhero dialogue. Like, it didn't have me thrilled at all. It felt like a generic trailer, right on down to this guy being interrogated, like the bad guy talking about the hero.
Oh, like the Mummy with the Dark Universe and
exactly. Like, I really wanted more Black Panther. I wanted to hear his story. I wanted to actually hear him have a goal and state it, at least in the movie somewhat. Man, and then the scene where they're showing him as a kid is no dialogue whatsoever, to the point that I'm just seeing like montages of the film at the beginning. Like, I felt no real drive to go see this movie. It felt like a generic superhero trailer. And I think what's really got to me most is how people are reacting to it, like it's the second coming of Christ. Like, y'all gave more shit to the Homecoming trailer than y'all gave them this one. This one has less stuff in it.
This stuff has stuff that looks more different. Like, that's the thing. Like, it's a teaser. I agree that there's not a lot in it. But compared to the Spider-Man one, Spider-Man, I guess, I'm excited for that one too, but it seems a more routine story and routine setting, like stuff we've seen before.
What are you talking about? It's a routine story here. Like, he's literally trained by his father, which is the old master, training the young superhero to come take over the mantle. And then they show that there's going to be a conflict, but that his father dies or the mental figure dies.
No, we already saw that. We saw that in Civil War.
Exactly.
Do we not forget that Creed is basically just Rocky?
Yeah, but you're right, though.
No, everyone gave him credit for Creed because he did it in a fresh way. So even if you've seen a story that's similar to something else, I feel like Ryan Coogler is going to do it in a very different approach, a fresh approach that people haven't seen before.
Well, I get that, but for me, from the teaser I watched, I'm not excited at all from what people are. They're acting like it was almost like another Star Wars film coming out, and I didn't get that reaction at all. It felt very bland. The hip-hop music reminded me of Luke Cage when they just had random hip-hop play in the background.
Yeah, like, it didn't really Run the Jewels that much. I mean, it's just like,
Run the Jewels, but even then, like, it sounded so generic because they weren't playing any of the chorus or any of the hardcore beats towards the middle. So it was just a beginning. It almost felt like how I felt during the Civil War trailer. Like, I'll just watch it when it comes out. I'm not really that hyped.
Yeah, and here's another thing, too. Like, people keep saying, it's a teaser trailer, Most trailers now are 2 minutes and 20 seconds, 2 minutes and 40, at the very, very most, 3. This trailer, and I'm going to show this type of screen over here, it's, what?
A minute 50.
It's about 2 minutes.
Yeah, 8 seconds less than fucking 2 minutes. And it's like, okay, like, I know it's called a teaser trailer, and that's awesome that you guys are calling it that, and it is, but you're, like, stuck on the word teaser and not realizing that this is damn near an actual trailer. Like, they're not showing us teaser shit, like a logo.
It feels like the Doctor Strange trailer. That one was very similar.
Yeah, but that teaser actually showed, like, a lot. Like, that was a teaser, and almost, it was about a minute and a half, but it actually kind of went through enough of almost the opening of the movie to give you an understanding of what the hell is going on. Like, I get Gonza's point with this. There's kind of a random mishmash of stuff happening.
Yeah. But that's kind of what a teaser is. I mean, they don't want to tell you everything right now.
Like I was getting some strong Suicide Squad vibes from this.
Oh, absolutely not.
I'm sorry, I'm with Gonsh on this, man. That was that first one when he played Finn.
I think y'all are judging this trailer too harshly.
Get behind me, Ellie. I'm with you, Ellie.
You're reviewing the movie. It's like, it's a trailer. It's a teaser. It's the first trailer. At least give it another trailer. A full-length trailer. At least show you something more, but it's like they just want to show people like a rough idea of how the movie's going to be, its themes and its tones, and I think it did that pretty well, at least.
Yeah.
But it's not supposed to give you anything right away.
But the Suicide Squad trailer gave you set tone and all that as well, and that's kind of how I felt with this movie. Now, I'm not saying it's going to be a shithole like Suicide was. Like, calm down, y'all. I'm just saying the same trailer hits those basic premises to me.
But see, that's the thing. With the Suicide Squad trailers, they were always iffy. Like, it was like the very first one they released at Comic-Con, I remember. It said, like, this very somber, like, stoic, dark tone. And then the next time you see it, it's all brightly colored, them playing rock music all throughout, trying to copy Guardians of the Galaxy. So, yeah, but your ballroom blitz and shit like that. So, it tried to, like, sell you on one thing, realize it didn't work, and then sell you another. I can't say I get that from Black Panther because he only had one.
Yeah, I mean, and here's the thing, too. Like, I agree with you in that sense, Rashad, but then, like, I think of all these other movies, like, you guys are all saying, like, no, well, they're not showing you a lot because it's a teaser, etc. But it's like, I Wonder Woman showed me a teaser, and literally, like, it showed me 2 of the 3 fucking fight scenes of Wonder Woman, and I'm just like, you know what, dude? Like, the last 3 comic book movies I watched, the teaser was the movie. And I'm just like, I'm sick of that shit. It's old, man.
But it's just okay, people. Just avoid the trailers for anything. Like, who's not going to watch into a Marvel movie at this point? Just avoid the trailers.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. Like, you're just saying, like, you think the whole movie. Can you tell me what the plot is for this film based on what's going on? Like, what the motivations of the villain are?
Honestly, I can guess it.
Well, let me ask you this, Justin. Let me ask you this really quick. Is this movie a comic book movie or a drama?
That's not fair, Nick. You can't just say that. You know what I mean? I'm saying, like, you can do things that are similar, but again, it's like Ali said, it's the execution. If it's still good to watch and still fun to watch, we can watch a movie, a story we know and we're familiar with, but we're still rewarded. Just like, yeah, it was still a fun time sitting there and enjoying it.
Yeah, well, okay, well, I'll basically just tell you what it is, because you're like, well, that's not fair. Like, no, I know what it is. It's fucking, it's a comic book movie trailer. Like, it's a comic book movie, you know?
No, so, you're right, Nick. We should make this more like Moonlight. We'll take all the dialogue out, and we'll just have a nice, somber look at the
politics of being king. Oh, my God, it'll be the first superhero movie to get an Oscar. That was amazing.
I understand where you're coming from, Nick. Believe me, I do. But it's like, I don't just apply that with comic book movies. I apply that with all movies. If I had never seen The Room and just, like, gone and watched the trailer, I could guess what's going to happen in that and just, like, not have even seen it. Like, oh, she was molested in this cellar. She gets out. She has problems. The kid is well-adjusting, but she's not. Like, I could get that, like, from the trailer, but it all boils down to how you enjoy it in the end.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Like,
I'm trying to say that perfectly, actually.
The trailers. Yeah. And I just felt it was generic. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah. Like, yeah. I mean, because people are saying, like, we're reading too much into it, and it's like, no, we're just saying, like, like, we're all reading equally into it. Like, we're all reading equally as much. It's just one side thinks it's shit and one side thinks it's good. Like, I mean, that's the only difference. We're all reading into it the same because that's what these are done for. Like, trailers aren't to be like, oh, that's happening, and then they move on. People talk about the shit. Right. So,
yeah. You know, I'll say for this trailer, I'm waiting for further trailers to see where this develops because the more trailers I see, like, for Spider-Man, the less interested I actually am in that movie.
Yeah, personally. I'm the same way, man.
Mm-hmm. And just to put this on your chest,
somebody get me a body bag.
Come on, man. At this point, like, I'm pretty sure you could piece together, like, the movie at this point, the amount of shit they put in the trailer.
Yeah, no, that's what I tried to avoid.
Make that two body bags, please.
Yeah, no, see, okay, yeah, you want to make the argument. So, like, the last two Spider-Man trailers spelled out the entirety of the plot for you, like, the plot progression. Yeah. So, how are you not angry at those, but you're angry at this one that tell you nothing?
I did complain about that, but at least they got me the drive of the character. They show me the character, what he's going through. Like, the first half of that trailer is just showing Spider-Man as a kid, just going through high school life, seeing what his basic life is before the superhero stuff comes into it.
And, you know, before we move on to the next thing, too, I just want to answer the Max's thing, because he says over here, like, does Nick just not like superheroes? That's the thing, I don't. But I love it when a movie can actually earn my respect, like The Dark Knight. Like, that shit earned it, where I was like, it wasn't a superhero movie. Like, you took that shit seriously, and it made sense why the dude in the bat costume was not fucking laughably ridiculous. They made it good. Like, many movies have done that, and it's just like, just do it again. Like, Spider-Man did it, the first three, I thought, except for the third one, actually. The third one was pretty fucking bad.
I love the third one. I don't care what anyone says.
But, you know, the first two.
You and Mark
fuck you two.
I mean, X-Men, I mean, dude, Cyclops is a ridiculous character, but after you get through all three, like, fucking X-Men movies, you're like, oh, shit, this
man, he's a ridiculous character.
No, I love Cyclops. He's awesome. Me too.
I don't know why anyone does, but that's another point.
But, like, everything, you know what I mean? So that's why I'm just kind of like, you know, like, I've been – it's okay to not like things, and then they win me over, and that's why I hope that this does, you know what I mean? Like, we'll